Hello, this is Lorraine at Wellness Gathering. We're doing a series of happiness with a steps to success, 6-week course. And this is week 3. And now I'm gonna toss it over to the facilitator and the host, my daughter, Lynne, to lead the class.
Thank you. So we are in week 3 of happiness with the 5 steps to success. And we are going to be, we've been looking at what we would want to focus on happiness for, what we want more of it for in our lives. And we also looked at, we were talking about intention. And then we also have looked at what more for, and each class will presenting a principle of core alignment coaching and emotional wisdom training, but we'll also be stepping through these 5 steps to success. And so we are going to be talking today about showing up. So we're going to go around, we're going to say our name. And the question for tonight is, what is something you like about life? So say your name, say where you are, and tell us something you like about life. So my name is Lynne, and I am in Calgary, Alberta. And something that I like about life is, well, I mean, I like this time of year because it's like all these little tiny buds are trying to poke out of the leaves and the birds are flocking around. And so I really like the seasons. I like the fact that we have a seasonal change, even though some of the seasons can be cold or very hot. But I do like, I like springtime because there's this sense of things really showing up. So it's interesting that we're going to be talking about showing up today. So, Olive?
My name's Olive and I'm in Saskatoon. What do I like about life? I like the change of seasons too, but I particularly like spring because to me it signifies a beginning, and with all the promise of good things ahead. So spring is full of optimism for me.
Thank you. Lorraine?
Okay,
my name is. Say where you are and tell us something you like about life.
My name is Lorraine and I'm in Osoyoos, British Columbia. And something that I like about life, well, I think what I like about life is just the life experiences that I've gone through. And of course, that's enjoying the seasons, nature, the adventures I had, and just being able to get up in the morning and breathe another breath of fresh air and just look out and see what's happening in the world, in nature, not on the internet.
Thank you. Awesome. Yeah, so it is. It's this time of year, there is that sense of new beginnings. And it's interesting because just even in speaking with you, Lorraine, before we started, we were really talking about showing up and what it means to show up. And you can tell what's important to somebody by where they show up in their life. And when it comes to our values and our value structure, that's often an indicator of where people show up, is an indicator of what their values are. So it's a good place to look at, what am I spending my money on? Where do I spend my time doing? And where am I actually showing up in my life? Those 3 things actually indicate what's really truly important to someone. But we are also looking at, where are we showing up in our lives with happiness, and what we would want. We've kind of dove into what we want more happiness for. But what would we want to show up with happiness for? Lorraine?
What, and the question is, what is showing
what
up
with
happiness?
What would we want to show up with happiness for?
What would we want? I think it's just keeping that frame of mind in that healthy situation. And it really, what you think is really affects your body. And it's so important to remind ourselves to try to be happy and look at even with a situation that really didn't seem to be all that rosy at the time, it can be turned around to make you feel better about it. If you know what affirmations to say or where to go to just to kind of neutralize that acidic thought that you have in your mind. So I think it's really a moment by moment, situation by situation, to be in a frame of mind to find happiness.
Yes, indeed. Olive, what do you think? What is showing up with happiness? What do you think it's for? How do you think, you know?
I think showing up with happiness is what you owe your fellow man. To show up with a negative attitude and just to show your worst self is not being fair to the other people in your life.
Yes, I mean, I kind of think of, you know, it's much lighter if I'm showing up in a state of upliftment than it is if I'm showing up in a down spiral. But what showing up with happiness is, you know, how it plays into it, what we want it more for. You know, making that choice to show up being cheerful and happy, you know, it's not to override maybe how I am feeling, but it definitely is a choice to show up in a lighter way. So some of the, so what does it really mean to show up in life? Olive?
To me, it means getting up in the morning every day with a positive attitude. And if that attitude isn't positive, I need to do something to adjust it. I need to do some exercise right away, or I need to do some meditation right away. But I need to get up every day with a positive attitude.
Well, you know,
what does it really mean, you know, to show up in life?
I think showing up, if you made a commitment, this is my take, if you make a commitment to be somewhere and you show up with, you know, it gives you credibility. It gives you that you're accountable to your actions and you're true to your word, that I'm going to be there at such and such a time, and the occasion is this, and I'm going to dress appropriately, and I'm going to be, it really reflects back on who you really are as a character and your credibility and accountability. And it sends out positive vibes that, you know, you might not feel that happy, but yet you're showing up with pride in yourself, and because you said you're going to do something. And the big thing is the credibility of your character.
Exactly. Yeah. So what does it really mean to show up in life? Part of, you know, it's about showing up. Yeah. For what I say I'm going to do, you know, it's about keeping my word and being in alignment with what I say. But showing up with happiness alongside is also, it's an indicator. It's true. It's an indicator of what, you know, am I standing up for myself? Am I showing up for what I say? So we are often in two places at the same time. Are here in the present, and the other half of us are back in the past. So to show up means to be fully present and active. To have your core in alignment means your yes is a yes and your no is a no, and you know the difference. So when all of our parts are in alignment, we have the capacity to truly show up as we accept the past, become aware of the present and awaken to the future. So what is it? Tell us a time that you showed up with happiness.
I missed the first part of that. Name a time when I showed up with happiness?
Yeah, tell us a time when you showed up with happiness.
Let me see. The one that comes to mind is we had a little mini family reunion with my sisters and my aunt at Watrous at the Manitou Springs Spa. And it was in the fall and I didn't really want to go. COVID was up and down. And I just said to myself, you know, my aunt who's 83 had planned this. She really wanted to do this. And I just decided it was up to us and up to me as an individual to show up and have a positive attitude about it and have fun. And I did. It was a good time.
Cool. Awesome. Lorraine?
Oh, I suppose what was the time that I showed up with happiness? Well, I could say it was the birth of my children, but that was all full of pain. But
it's sort of a mixed emotion.
It was a very mixed emotion, especially, you know, anyway, so I thought I better really mention that. But I remember showing up I really felt deep happiness. It was really weird. And we were hitchhiking in Austria. We were headed back to Switzerland. And we stayed in this little place in the Tyrol Mountains in Austria. And it was called Wolfgang Z. And Marion and I decided to go to this bar. We could hear music playing, and it was like the old country music from the Melody Ranch Boys in Saskatchewan. That's what I reflected on. So we went there, we got all propitzed up, took off our hiking clothes and got propitzed, and we went out to the bar, and it was so invigorating because it was lively. And then of course we were in our 20s and there was these young guys there, and of course we danced, and then some they took us home. But I really had that, I wrote in my journal that day that I was so, I felt so light and so happy. And that really stuck to me, you know, when I think of being really happy. And it was just sort of, you know, what we did, you know, in the evening once we hitchhiked for several hours in different rides to get to where we're going. But that really sticks in my mind. And it was just so much fun. And I think the young fellow that walked me home was Hans.
So what was it that made you sense of happiness?
I don't know. It was just a feeling that came over me and listened to the music and just take part in what was going on, because in that country, and you know, that was in the 60s, 1960, it was summertime anyway, but in August, and it would just seem to be, it was just a lot of fun, and we were looking for some fun.
Cool. Awesome.
But I just remember writing in my journal, I just felt so happy. And you don't write these things very often. You know, I'm happy. Usually it was terrible because we didn't get rides and we were dirty and didn't have hot water and the beds weren't comfortable in the youth hostel. So we always had a lot of complaints. But that particular thing is really still, I still feel that feeling in my heart today.
Got it. Yeah, a time that I showed up with happiness. I think there's quite a few. Well, I mean, I guess it was just a little while ago. my daughter's boyfriend's parents were visiting from France, and they speak nothing but we speak English, they speak French, and they came into the house. And of course I wish it was sort of like a comedy show. And because, you know, I just felt like it doesn't really matter that we can't speak each other's language. We can just enjoy each other's company. And by the end of it, we were playing cards. And even though we knew how to play the game, by the end of it, I was able to speak French and they were able to speak. And so that's a time that I remember showing up with happiness. And I think it was the biggest thing is because Jeremy is such a sweet man. I'm so grateful that Kaney has found this nice dude. And so to meet his parents just made me really happy, because it was like, it could really see where he's come from. And even though there's a language barrier, it motivates me to really want to learn more languages. It's like, what would it take to be able to speak many languages with ease? So
practice,
yes. So we are looking at showing up and what it means to show up. So how did you make that happen? How did you make showing up with happiness happen?
With the situation
in
the fall?
Yeah.
I think I just decided that it was going to work. There was the weather was very unpredictable, but we seem to have had a lull in the weather. So my aunt and her daughter were able to drive from Lethbridge without incident. Just sometimes I think the universe just aligns to make things happen. And I think it helps if you have the right attitude.
Well, and the choice, hey? And this is the thing. Making the choice. And that's how, you know, with looking at happiness with all of these principles, it really is a choice. And we can add it at any time. Mm-hmm. What about you, Lorraine?
I don't know if I set out to make the situation happy. I think if you just make the decision to do what you were asked to do or committed to or invited to do, and you do it, and it just turns out to be happy. I mean, you know, and I think it because you are not in a real negative state of mind, you're just going to, okay, I'm going to do this. And I don't think that you really think about it. It just happens. It's like the universe is speaking to you.
Got it. That alignment, yeah, that showing up. So what difference does showing up really make?
I think you respect other people's lives and situations by showing up. If you don't show up, I think that's disrespectful.
I quite agree with you all of that. Is, you know, respect and be conscious of the other person. If she drove from Lethbridge to Watrous and you didn't show up, wouldn't you feel awful? But it is, it really is respecting other people. And that reverberates that back to yourself, to respect yourself, because you're saying, okay, this has been planned. Let's just do this. And it really does reflect on our personal character as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's really choosing it, like choosing, I'm going to show up. I said I was going to show up. I might not have wanted, but then all of a sudden there's presence. It's like I'm all of a sudden just 100% present with what it is, in spite of whatever the limitation is, or the perceived limitation. And it is that sense of respect, deserving of respect, you know, not respecting myself, respecting others, and recognizing I may not get the respect. You know, I can give respect, but I may not get the respect. So how can I show up in spite of, and just be present with that? And I think it's like you said, it's like that alignment happens. And then there's just that sense of presence, and that presence brings more happiness because I'm showing up as I am and there's nothing interfering. So it can't be anything but joy. So we always wrap up with our two questions. So we've been focusing on showing up and showing up with happiness and what it means. So what will you take with you from our call today that will support you until we talk again?
I'll take the responsibility of respecting other people's time and lives by showing up for them, both physically and emotionally.
Yeah. And what I'll take away from this conversation until we speak again, meet again, is just analyzing the importance of showing up and being happy, or even if it's not easy to be, come to that, but just finding the lighter things and being in line with in that the situation and making a decision. And it there's always a lot of ways of overcoming situations as you think you're like it really is piling on you, but it's the acknowledgement of just doing it.
And what I take away is this awareness of showing up, but you know, with the volatility of the times, I've been noticing that what's truly important is where I'm what I'm showing up for. So if my kids are not feeling well, or there's a crisis, you know, it's like I have to be willing to shift. You know, I've been hearing that from a lot of people. You know, it's like they've just had to take care of themselves, and that's been the most important thing that they can do. And so they're showing up for themselves, and that to me is a testament to really being in alignment with what's real and true for me and for the others in my life. And it shows me what is really important is where I'm showing up. And so I kind of take away that awareness that even if I say I'm going to go and do something, I can show up for that. But you know, if there's an accident or something that happens, that's where I'm going to show up as well. And sometimes those things are out of my control, but I still choose to show up there and show up in the best way possible, similar to what you were saying, Olive. It's like, I might not have wanted to go, but I showed up anyways and had a good time, right? Yeah. And it's, you know, it's really showing up for other people and respecting them and respecting myself in the process. So what will you take with you from this conversation that will support you for the rest of your life?
I will take the importance of being physically and emotionally present. One of the things I appreciate about this group is nobody is on other devices while we're talking. My son is a teacher, and he said one of the most frustrating things about online teaching was that he knew every student had at least one other device they were paying attention to, probably three. And I appreciate that we are giving each other the gift of time.
That is really perfect.
It's very true.
Yeah.
And I guess that's the value of, you know, when we used to be able to be present in body with each other, you know, it's much easier for anybody to be present if it's physical, right?
What
I'll take away for the rest of my life is the fact that if we talk about it and we practice it and we just dissect it, and it just brings those awareness things in your mind that, gee, this is what you know, it's so much easier to do. It's like, Lynne, like learning a new language is practice. Yeah. And be aware of there is so many alternatives, and to really look after yourself is so important. So that will certainly support me for the rest of my life.
Mm-hmm. What I will take with me that'll support me for the rest of my life is that we are living in unprecedented times, and that it has been extremely challenging for every generation to navigate navigate what we've been navigating. And I think that it takes some of these principles and these practices to be shared, not only over like a format like this, but to be shared in life. But it also is an indicator of what people value and what others value, and that it's okay to really dive into what's truly important for me. And it's truly okay to appreciate what other people are holding true for them. So to me, sharing these principles and these practices is foundational. It's like you were just saying, it's like doing weightlifting for the mind.
And
not only noticing where I'm showing up, but noticing where my kids show up, you know, noticing when my husband shows up, and that where he's showing up is totally in alignment for him or others for that matter. So I'd like to be able to share more of these principles for the rest of my life.
Okay. Well, thank you very much, Lynne. I think this has been a very fruitful discussion, and I'm going to stop the recording, and then I'm going to be posting it and sharing it out again, and we'll do lesson 4 next Monday. Okay.